to BW Business World. Today we are here at BW Education's Leadership Summit 2023. I have with me Ms. Poojana Santana, who is CEO of Global Outreach of Sri Satya Sai Loka Seva Gurukulam Group of Institutions. Welcome.
Thank you so much.
So good to have you.
Thank you.
We are talking in the backdrop of how the education industry per se is evolving.
Yeah.
Tell us about your journey with the group. And
yes.
also what is the group is focusing on right now.
Right. Thank you so much for having me here. And this is the Sri Satya Sai Loka Seva Gurukulam Group of Institutions. And we also have the higher education wing, which is the Sri Satya Sai University for Human Excellence. We start from grade 6 all the way up to PhD.
Mm-hmm.
And we provide, in fact, we call it, we gift education. It's absolutely free of charge. No charges at all to the children. We have about 27 campuses in India across Karnataka, Telangana and Tamil Nadu.
Mm-hmm.
We also have a school in Nigeria, in Laos and also in Australia. Put together, we've got about 5,000 children studying with us. Free values-based integral education is what we bestow. And this is based on the principle that we need to educate children not only for the mind, but also for the heart and for the hands. So typically what happens is we tend to concentrate on giving them education for the mind and for the hands, that you skill them.
That's right.
But somewhere in that process, we forget to nurture their hearts,
mm-hmm.
Which is the most important. And that's what we focus on and believe in, which is the whole values-based part, which is the holistic and the integral development of a child sort of comes into focus. And at the core of all of this, that is what we say, the 3H formula, that is head, heart and hand.
All of it.
And which is infused with a lot of love,
mm-hmm.
because 75% of our enrollment is from underprivileged backgrounds.
Mm-hmm.
And that is the reason all our campuses are situated in rural hinterlands of India.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the reasons that we do that is, of course, you know, as we know, almost 70% of India is in the rural villages.
That's right.
And accessibility and affordability sort of becomes a big question mark, in a lot of places. So hence the decision by our founder, Sadhguru Srimad Sudhan Sai. So we are all, marching forward with his guidance, where every child is embraced, irrespective of caste, creed, ethnicity and culture. And this sort of a equal education is given to everyone. So it is all state of the art, magnificent edifices, across all our campuses. And one of the key things that we believe in and which we do in our campuses, which are all residential, by the way, is that our teachers, our professors stay with the students in the hostels. Because, we believe, that sort of, creates that bond
mm-hmm.
between them. And, that helps the child to sort of also, grow in a way that, they're able to see their mentor, they're able to see their teacher or their professor with them.
Yeah, they can see their walk, their talk. Yeah?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And that's why. So here, values-based education is not, a curriculum, or it's not 1 hour in a day.
Mm-hmm.
It is the culture of the entire campus. So we can say that right from a chairperson, the principal mm-hmm. of that particular campus, all the way up till the last child, the human values of love and peace and non-violence and truth and all of this is practiced through the day.
Yeah.
So I would say that is possibly one of the key aspects which has helped. And what we see is that this has created a lot of gratitude in the hearts of the children.
That's right. That's right.
Otherwise, what happens is these children could have just been left behind.
Mm-hmm.
They wouldn't have got the education which is required. Like we always say, it's important to ensure that every single child passes through that system of education and gets educated so that they can be contributing citizens and serve the country and serve their communities better.
That's right. How lovely. I am highly impressed with the 3H approach: head,
heart and hands.
How lovely. And of course, the culture you're creating in every place and corner at your campuses is worth appreciating.
Yes.
Now, can we look at like blending the two of the things? The one is, which is coming from your core philosophy that's round about all things around the values first, and then going forward with the curriculum and teaching the teaching the students.
Right.
But we are now right now standing at where we are talking about hybrid learning, we are talking about technology getting embedded in. What do you have to say? What strategies, what plans are working for you well when you look at teaching and educating those students which are not too privileged and not too at the forefront of this tech aid, if I can say?
Right.
What strategies are working there?
I would say that we need to relook at that aspect of it. Because not a lot of children across India have equitable access to a computer or a laptop or, you know, something like that. So what we did, for example, during COVID is, you know, obviously kids had to go back into their villages, etc. So here we are speaking of online learning. But in some of those villages, there's no internet connectivity. Right? Or even if there is internet or even if there is network, it doesn't reach them. So that last mile connectivity, as we call, is extremely crucial. The second aspect is they may not necessarily afford a smartphone.
That's right.
Or they may not necessarily have, you know, a ThinkPad or an iPad or, you know, a tablet, basically. So what we did is we ensured that every child had that access. So we provided that access to the children, so learning did not stop for them. And, we ensured that, the network in those areas, you know, to a large extent was, accessible to them. And it was, you know, it did work for us from that perspective. So I think while from an urban cities perspective, we can talk about, the digital learning. Again, I'm coming back to the fact that much of India are still in the rural areas.
And so
that, obviously, that piece really needs to be looked at as well.
Yeah, needs to be embraced well. Going forward, we are in the first month of the year. What are new projects? What are new initiatives we can expect from you?
I would say our biggest vision, and which is the vision of our founder, Sadhguru Srimadsudan Sai, is to ensure until that last child is educated, until that last child is fed, until that last child, his or her health is taken care of, our mission doesn't stop. We are not only in the vertical of education, we are also in the vertical of nutrition and healthcare too. So in nutrition, every single morning we provide breakfast to 1.2 million children across 16,000 schools in the country, all government schools. And also what we do, which is across, 23 states and 4 union territories. In the healthcare space, we are the world's largest single specialty hospitals, which is pediatric cardiac hospitals, which are present in India and in Sri Lanka and in Fiji Islands. So as we live to serve children, that's what we call ourselves, and our motivation is that child. So that child is well read, is nourished and is healthy, and we are here only for children.
How lovely. Are you also collaborating with the government of India
on various aspects? Yes,
because when we are now in the year 2023, we are very much as the industry is very much focused on new education policy.
True.
Getting imbibed in all of the curriculums across the parameters, be it from the early school or let's say higher education.
Right.
What are your plans with it, and how do you plan to
absolutely
forward?
So whatever is the mandated in the NEP 2020. So we will be going forward with all those interventions and whatever has been said. Yeah, absolutely.
So good to have you, and so good to
thank
know about
you so
this
much.
Initiative. I have been impressed. Thank you. Thank you
so much.